Ladies and gentlemen, from the Venetian Macau, the action continues, and it's all brought to you by Top Rank Incorporated, sponsored by Tecate Con Carácter. This is World Championship Boxing, sanctioned by the PBCC Executive Director, Leon Panoncillo. IBF Supervisor ringside, Lindsay Tucker. The three judges scoring will be Patricia Jarman, Sylvain LeBlanc, Chris Wilson, and inside the ring in charge of the action at the bell, referee Ernest Sharif. And now from the Venetian Macau, this is 12 rounds of boxing for the IBF Lightweight Championship of the World. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing white, official weight 134¾ pounds. As a professional, an outstanding record, consisting of 34 fights, 33 victories, including 18 knockouts with one draw, from Mias, Russia. He's the challenger, the undefeated, Denis Chingis Khan Shafiko. And his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the red corner, wearing blue, officially weighing in at 134¾ pounds. Also, an outstanding professional record, 33 victories, including 13 knockouts, only 3 defeats, and he's undefeated for the last 4 years. From Guadalajara, Jalisco, Mexico, the reigning and defending IBF lightweight champion of the world, Miguel Angel Titerre Vasquez.
Are you guys, you have received your instructions in the dressing room. I want you to obey my commands at all time and protect yourself at all time. Do you have any questions? Any questions? Touch them up and go.
Vasquez's only defeats have been by bigger men, Timothy Bradley, and twice to Canelo Alvarez. He is one of the top 3 or 4 lightweights in the world. Not a very deep division. The question is he willing to sell out the way, for example, Timothy Bradley did when he decided he's got to earn everybody's respect and he went to war with Provodnikov? Is he willing to put on a show like that to make himself not just a comfortable winner and making a comfortable living, but really get to the top shelf?
We're into round one of a scheduled 12-round championship bout here between Miguel Vasquez and Denis Shafikov. And you mentioned it, Larry, that since that loss to Canelo Alvarez, he was fighting at a higher weight class. They basically made a determination that he was fighting in the wrong weight class because his power certainly wasn't translating as a welterweight or even as a junior. So they dropped down all the way to lightweight, and so far, so good.
You know, earlier we just saw a few seconds ago the problem when you fight a southpaw and an orthodox fighter, their feet are going to get tangled up quite a bit. And Vasquez stepped on Shafikov's foot, and I expect a lot more of that because Shafikov has a wide stance, and you know, coming forward, Vasquez is in and out. So we'll see if that has any effect on anything.
And Shafikov is in the white trunks. Vasquez in the blue trunks, and Shafikov is going to move forward here.
Ooh, good punch.
He's fought just one time in the United States. That was his last fight, and he came up victorious with a 7th-round knockout.
Right.
And he trains at Wild Card Gym. Ernie Zavala is his trainer, but Freddie Roach is his second tonight. And Freddie said, look, I would not have taken this guy in if I didn't think he had a great work ethic and he wasn't focused. And Shafikov certainly seems to be serious here, as he's quickly determined to be one of the top contenders in the lightweight division. But here you see what Vasquez does so well. He moves around the ring, and he's going to throw quick 1-2 combinations, get in, bang, bang, and then move around and get out.
Well, that's the thing he's doing. He's given a lot of angles. He's given a lot of angles. He is good on his feet. But I think, as Larry alluded to earlier, he's got to start throwing more punches to get, you know, be more fan-friendly if he expects to make any type of big money. But this is the type of fight could be, it's a good fight so far. I'm enjoying it. As long as Shavkov keeps coming forward. Vasquez, he's not holding a lot. You can see he's doing a lot of movement. It'd be a real good fight.
Shavkov trying to find the key to the door that will get him inside the phone booth here with Miguel Vasquez early on.
Good round for the champion.
Mira, está muy bien, pero de repente tira el 1-2, de repente volado y recto, y cámbiasela, ya vea, y de repente el jab, el upper, y ya véalo, de repente la pea, por dentro, ¿eh? Está, está hecho para ti, está hecho para ti ese cabrón.
Okay. You go on that side, you go on that side next round, I want him to shoot his left hand, and then hook to the body, and then hook to the head, right?
You know, Vasquez has a similar problem to the Cuban fighter Rigondeaux. You know, they're really good, slick, quick technicians, but not fan friendly. And they have something to prove, even though they're on top. Rigondeaux may be fighting in one of the fights here in China later in the summer.
Well, that's why tonight it could be a big night for Vasquez. He's got Shavkov, who likes to charge forward. If he can catch him, put on some type of exciting display, then that could start to turn his fortunes. And you saw in the corner the gentleman talking to Vasquez. His father is in his corner as well, Miguel Vasquez Sr. He was a former fighter, had 14 or 15 pro fights, and he used to get beat up a lot in the ring, he told us.
Fathers seldom want to see their kids get beaten up.
That's right. Oh, I'm trust me, I know that.
But no, and so that's why you see Vasquez. I mean, he's adopted this style. He also has two brothers who are amateur boxers as well, and they fight the same way. And your point is a good one, Larry, that he doesn't want to see his kids take the same kind of punishment he took.
But I got to tell you, Fred, I think a lot of it's because of his physical size. He's 5'10". You don't make a big guy fight small.
Well, you're right. That often determines, how you're going to fight. And we're seeing very graphic examples at him. Both fighters here.
Right.
Shavkov doing some nice body work inside as Vasquez continues to counter from the outside. 1-2 and get away. But you'll also occasionally you'll see a lead right hand from Vasquez. He is quick. He's very technical.
He's going to have to be in great shape, which it looks like he is in great shape, to keep moving like this for 12 rounds.
This should be the peak of his career, 27, 28 years old, 33 professional fights. He is who he is. And it's really hard asking somebody who he is and has established himself to make changes.
Right. No, at this point, that's not going to happen. Hopefully he gets the right opponents, because styles make fights, as we've said. And like a Shavkov, as long as he's coming forward, he'll put on a good. I mean, if he has fights like this, he can put on a good show.
Well, that remains to be seen. We're two rounds into the first of 12, Ray.
He moves good. I'm saying, as a move, he's trying to throw punches. He's trying to make a go of it. Make it action. He's not a puncher. The bottom line, Mexicans like to see big guys go down. He's not a puncher.
Nice body shot that time by Vasquez. Catch Shavkov coming in.
March 1st, World Championship Boxing returns with the highly anticipated rematch between Julio Cesar Chavez Jr. and Brian Vera. Chavez won a highly contested decision last September. Also that night, Two-time Olympic champion Vasyl Lomachenko, in only his second pro fight, challenges Orlando Salido for a featherweight title.
La derecha se la puede repetir. ¿Eh? No lo dejes llavear, no te desesperes. ¿Eh?
Right, and you have to be first. You know, going into these fight, into this fight, both of them knew or had a good idea of how it would go because they've sparred some. And the question is, can the challenger really fight one of those almost reckless fights? Just not be just relentless, but sometimes be reckless to try to hurt him and slow him down.
There you saw Vasquez pointing out a clash of heads, which Reyes, what you said typically is going to happen when you have a southpaw going up against an orthodox fighter. Nice short right hand catches Vasquez from Shapovalov there.
See, what Shapovalov is doing now is with our friend Angelo Dunn used to say, don't ring around the rosy. You know, he's not cutting him off. He's following him. And he's not going to be successful unless he starts stepping over, cutting off the ring, making the ring shorter for Vasquez.
You put it well, because, first of all, the ring looks huge.
It is. Right. Right.
Yeah, I don't know how big this ring is. And, you know, it's a perfect playing field for Vasquez.
Shapovalov, though, started to get a little bit closer to Vasquez.
He's willing to take 2-3-5 to try to get something going.
Nice solid 1-2 from Vasquez. He steps back. Shapovalov misfires. Vasquez comes right back with a blow to the head.
You know, the one thing I see Shapovalov not do, and what smaller fighters coming in, coming forward against big guys have to do, trust me, take it from someone who knows, you got to come in behind the jab. You got to stick the jab out. Even if you don't hit him, you got to let him know you got it. Throw the jab out, move your head side to side. If you just come in with your hands down, you're not going to break the guy down. You're not going to be able to, you know, you got to jab him up, jab him down. Make him think. Let him know that you got it.
Nice counter left from Vasquez. Upstairs, but Vasquez is also doing a nice job trying to do some work to Shapovalov's body, see if he can slow him down a little bit. So you see Vasquez very tactical, delivers another uppercut. You mentioned the sparring session, Larry. It's interesting because they had two different takes. Vasquez said, look, Shapovalov, we sparred for 4 rounds. I figured out he was a strong fighter. Shapovalov says he didn't learn that much from him. Vasquez just ran around, and basically he wasn't asked back to spar. So he didn't think it was that great of a session. Oh, nice lead right hand to end the third round there from Denis Shapovalov, who's trying to upset the lightweight champion Miguel Vasquez.
Deep breath. Deep breath. Take a deep breath. Dennis, listen to me. You have to be first. Don't box with him. All right? I want you to walk right to him, side to side, drill him, jab, jab, left hand, uppercut, left hand.
You hear me? Okay.
Todo bien. Síguelo llaveando y alrededor, pero no te le quede. Tú nomás dale vueltita por un lado y de repente, y pam, pam. Ope recto, volado recto. Todo le entra, güey. Es bravo, pero hasta ahí nomás, güey. Ahorita va a caer. La goma.
Seconds out.
Great, good advice from the corner there from Ernie Zavalov, who is Shapovalov's trainer. Have to be first.
Yeah, absolutely. You can't let a big guy get off on you first. As you come up forward, that's what I'm saying. You tap him. You hit him in the shoulder. You hit him in the waist. You hit him anywhere you can. Just keep him. Let him know that you're coming forward. And as long as you keep touching him, you make him react to you.
both fighters trying to do some damage to the midsection.
Well, nice cut over the left eye, or on the side of the left eye of Vasquez.
We'll have to see if that was from a headbutt, or I think it looks like it was. As the referee, Ernest Sharif, separates the two fighters, and you can see already it's bothering Vasquez. He's pawing at it with his left hand.
Yeah, not in a good place, not in a good place. Not a lot of blood yet, as it keeps going.
We'll see if Shapovalov now starts to concentrate on that cut here.
Vasquez is sort of standing his ground a little bit here, trying to put a little hurt, slow up the charge.
Jumps in first with that lead left hook, and then a looping right, comes back with an uppercut.
He's fighting now. Everything I heard about him, really. He's fighting.
Sometimes blood has a tendency to wake up a little bit in the ring.
Yes, it does. Trust me. There is a bit of urgency he's feeling right now. Trust me.
We've seen it a few times in this round. That lead left uppercut from Vasquez, it catches Shapovalov again. So it appears that there was an accidental headbutt in this round. And Vasquez has done a little less dancing and a little more toe-to-toe throwing.
Well, Vasquez has to watch. He's throwing them uppercuts, both hands from far, too far out. He comes in, he's going to get caught with the, you know, with the overhand, right or left.
It's about the fourth time in the fight that Vasquez has looked over to Sharif. He's basically complaining about the headbutts, and he's wearing a pretty nasty cut over his left eye. Shapovalov caught him there as Vasquez was backing up.
Well, I don't know if this is a good thing or a bad thing for Vasquez, because suddenly he's becoming more of a boxer puncher and less of a pure boxer.
Yes. No, I understand. He is initiating some action.
And you know what? This is the kind of fight that Shapovalov was definitely looking for. There's no doubt about that. You guys said, get him off his game here as the fourth round comes to an end. And then see if he could make a brawl of it and catch Vasquez. So there's an accidental headbutt there in the fourth round. And Vasquez's corner is going to go to work on the cut right over his left eye. All right, Ray, let's take a look here at the headbutt here in the fourth round.
Boom, there it is. Yep. Two guys coming in. Both again, there's Vasquez throwing an uppercut.
I'm not sure that was that it, because he went to the other side of Vasquez.
And that is a Ruben Gomez, the cut man in the corner for Vasquez, going to work. So we're through four rounds, so if the fight has to be stopped because of that headbutt, they'll go to the scorecards as we start the fifth round here. It's a lightweight championship bout between Miguel Angel Vasquez, making his sixth title defense, going up against one of the top contenders in Denis Shapovalov. And Sharif warning Vasquez about leaning down there on the neck and the upper back of Shapovalov.
Break.
I don't think I've seen any of these fighters with V's in their name lose lately. Good right hand by Vasquez.
Well, you know, one of the reasons why Vasquez is not a big puncher, I think, as we see, he doesn't put no snap behind it. He doesn't put no hurt behind it. It's just arm punches right now.
Well, if he's on his toes and moving the way he does, if he has power, haven't seen it.
Right. No, you're right, Larry. He's got to sit down on his punches before he throws them to get any sort of hurt behind it.
Nice quick right hand there from Vasquez. Second one that's caught Shapovalov here in the fifth round. And Vasquez has gone to these looping uppercuts And Ray, I'm seeing him wide open after those uppercuts.
That's what I'm saying. Shevchenko, if he catches him coming in, he times it right. And I'm sure I'm hoping, or his corner should be telling him that, to watch when this guy goes that wide uppercut, just throw a straight left hand or throw that right hook.
That's Sharif telling Vasquez to watch the holding there. So first he was leaning down on Shevchenko. And then he gets warned about the hold. Vasquez doing more body work.
There you go.
This is his first fight, by the way, in 14 months. He had a fight scheduled for last March, but it ended up being postponed. He's supposed to fight Ricky Burns. Whether there was reportedly a viral infection, there also was a report that he wasn't happy with the money. Nevertheless, that fight didn't happen, so his last fight came against Mercedo Hesta back in December of 2012. It was on the undercard of the Pacquiao Marquez 4 fight. So he said rust isn't going to be an issue for him. Ray, anything you've seen tonight from Vasquez that stood out to you that, what the guy looks like, a guy who's had a pretty long layoff?
No, because the guys that are boxers, guys like my style come forward. You can't afford to take a long layoff because, part of our style being forward aggression is throwing punches, timing. A guy who moves, after a couple of rounds, you'll get the pace of the fight back.
Cut seems to be under control here as round 5 comes to a close. Could this fight start to turn the corner here? Tuesday night at 10 p.m., catch the next Real Sports for an investigative look at how the firearms industry is targeting new customers, children. But how young is too young?
I want you to double up on the left hand, go straight to the body, and then go hook to the head and beat to the
right? We talked about the uppercuts as Vasquez tries to work the body. And there he catches Shapokov with a right hand. Here's another one, Ray.
Again, far outside. Shevchenko, corner is a tell him. Try to time that with a straight left hand. I'm telling you, it'll change the things around.
It's Miguel Vasquez Sr. talking to his son as he gets set for the 6th round here. Kotai Arena, Fran Charles, alongside Ray Boom Boom Mancini and Larry Merchant. 5 rounds are in the books for this lightweight championship between Miguel Vasquez and southpaw Denis Shapokov, one of the top contenders in the lightweight division.
Don't push my hand. Box!
Nice straight right there. Good jab from Shapokov.
Great.
Starting to get a little rough.
We're going to stop this fight in a few seconds because of the tape. There we go.
There you go. Hey, Mancini, you know what he's talking about.
I'm a psychic.
Right there,
I'm a psychic. I'm a psychic.
You're right on top of it, right?
But you got to watch that. They're running in and out. Shavkov's coming forward. Vasquez is in and out. I'm telling you, they're going to bang heads again. They've just missed a few times.
Vasquez going back to another uppercut to start his assault. Sharif a lot busier here in the 6th round than he's been in any other round of the fight so far between these two fighters.
I gotta tell you, I'm pleasantly surprised at Vasquez because everything I had heard is he doesn't appreciate the action. He won't throw a lot of punches. I'm telling you, he's putting on a good show.
Don't do it.
Well, I think that mainly because Shevchenko is making him fight.
Oh, no, you're right. No, that's what I said. Styles make fights. This is a good style.
Well, Vasquez called it hunting the bull. That's what he told us when we met with him. That he knows Shevchenko is going to pressure him. And that's what every fighter, he says, and that he steps into the ring with. That's their big game plan. He says they all think it's going to work, and it has not worked as of late. So he just wants to play the matador. but he seems to be planting a little bit more and willing to engage. At what point, Ray, too, as a fighter, do you start to make the determination that you don't think a fighter can hurt you, and so that way then you might be a little bit more willing to engage? I'm not saying that's what's definitely happened here. But the action seems to be drawn a little bit closer.
Well, you learn that early on. Early in the first couple rounds, every guy's got the best power in early rounds.
Shapovalov trying to up the tempo here in the sixth round, trying to find a way to cut off this ring. Haven't seen him been able to get really Miguel Vasquez against the ropes. If he can get Vasquez against the ropes, then maybe he might have an opportunity to do a little bit of damage. We have not seen that yet so far in this fight.
Dennis, okay, every time you
Shevchenkov says that the area he comes from in the Urals, which have produced so many fighters, is a drab place filled with bad, desperate guys. And this is the way to get out of there. So we're looking at a desperate guy who knows that, or feels, as the Russian fighters do, that the only place you can be is at the top to get noticed. And the only place you can realize your dreams after you've been an amateur or even a star amateur is to go somewhere else, because there isn't a big professional prize fight scene in Russia.
Well, he's fought all over the world, no doubt about that. Russia, Finland, Scotland, Mexico.
Break,
Belarus.
Break. Last
4 years in Finland.
Don't push down on his head. Box.
And also, his last fight was in the United States. He wants to see if he can make that transition. And figures tonight is his ticket. He's got five rounds left. Go ahead, Ray, to put on a little bit more of an exciting show to see if some of the U.S. boxing fans will take a bite.
You were saying earlier about how to start feeling a guy's power. First of all, you know by the knockouts he has or doesn't have. You watch enough tape, you could see if he's a punch. At this point, I think you're right. Shevchenkov got to come start to try to walk through Vasquez. He's still trying to box him, stay outside too much. Cut off the ring, make it a dogfight. That's what he has to do.
Now we've got blood coming.
From the right side.
That's right. And also, top of his head as well there on the left side.
I think that's blood from the cut.
Okay.
Vasquez's cut.
So we'll keep an eye on that here in the seventh round. Shapovalov short started out nice and white and pure and clean.
Ooh,
and now they got a little red tinge to them. We've got a couple of headbutts in this match. Now you see the blood streaming from the right eye of Denis Shapovalov. So we'll see what Vasquez does if he tries to go to work on that cut.
Well, Shevchenkov's going to have a good cut man in his corner. Miguel Diaz, one of the best in the game.
Doubt about that. 30 seconds left here in the seventh round.
Ooh.
Nice uppercut from Vasquez. Takes one shot though and backs out. Crowd's starting to get a little restless. I want to see a little bit more action. End of the seventh. Miguel Diaz is going to go to work.
Look now at Vasquez trying to do some work here in the seventh round, and this is what he does well, Ray. 1-2, and he gets out.
He does, friend, but you... There's Shevchenko here. Boom, good. Straight right jab, straight jab. Short right hand. Boom, try to throw another hand over the top. Because what Vasquez is doing, he's throwing those uppercuts, but he's coming forward with his head, you know, with his chin out there. And part of the reason why they're butting heads, because he's throwing his punches and he's coming forward.
The fight's close.
So those are the hands of Miguel Diaz. Trying to work on the cut there of Denis Shapovalov. In the blue corner. So we'll see how the cut over the right eye affects Shapovalov. The one on the over the left eye of Vasquez was taken care of. So these cut men doing a nice job as we start the eighth round of a scheduled 12-round lightweight championship between Miguel Angel Vasquez and Denis Shapovalov. Tito Ray, Vasquez is a nickname. It says he got it early. They called him the puppet because he liked to move around a lot. And certainly we're seeing that tonight.
See, when Vasquez stops to come in and punch, that's when Shevchenko has to fire right back with him. You got to punch with him. And that's the only way you can slow a guy like Vasquez down.
So far, mostly because of Vasquez's skill and ring sense, Shevchenko just looks like a tough plugger. Doesn't have the stuff to slow Vasquez down, much less beat him.
There's a nice textbook tackle there for Vasquez if he were on the football field.
I mean, he has to know, his corner has to know, everybody in the arena knows that the only way he can win this fight is by making something dramatic happen.
See, you're allowing him to throw those wide punches. That's my point. He's allowing a tall guy throw the wide punches from the outside. He's got to shorten that distance. Keep coming forward, backing Vasquez up, where he's got no shot to win.
And that's where he wants to get him on the ropes, but Shevchenko has not been able to do it. Let's give Vasquez some credit here as well. He hasn't lost in nearly 6 years, and he ended up grabbing the lightweight championship back in 2010. He's had a couple of tough fights. And you mentioned it early, Larry, that his three losses, two of them are to Canelo Alvarez. One was a pro debut, it was four rounds, but then later it was at welterweight. And the other, Timothy Bradley, had a tough victory against Brandon Prescott, where he was knocked out in the first round, hurt in the second round, but he came back and won that fight. So there's some toughness there. He's never been stopped.
Great. Back,
you were saying earlier, friend, that he fought Canelo at welterweight. You could see with the tall frame he has that he could carry that weight.
But the issue is, he's got enough problems with power at 135. There's not going to be a whole lot of power at 147. And that really is a dilemma here for Vasquez. Good look at Cotai Arena heading into the later rounds here. Shapovalov, we're trying to figure out a way to cut off this ring against the champion Vasquez.
Second down, sir. Get out of the ring. Fox.
A little friendly banter between Sharif and Miguel Diaz there. You got a little box. So it's the ninth round here. And there's a nice jab from Shapovalov, but he's got to find a way to get Vasquez up against the ropes and keep him there. So we know what the dilemma is for Vasquez in terms of people might not necessarily think this is an appetizing fight, this style. What about other guys, though, in the lightweight division, Larry, who probably don't want to fight him either because it's hard to look good against him because you can't catch him.
It's hard to beat him. It's hard to look good against him. It's hard to make money for fighting.
Right.
One, two, three. Maybe three is the most important in terms of making the money. Maybe that should have been number one.
Worst type of opponent to fight.
Well, right now, the lightweight division is... No need for a pun here, but light a little bit.
Yeah, well, the hope is Mikey Garcia, a California kid from the fighting family. He's most likely going to be fighting Gamboa at lightweight in his next fight. Could be a good fight.
Stop
that. Minute left here in the night. You can see Shapovalov running out of steam a little bit.
Both of you are holding. You're holding. You're holding. Stop holding. Box.
And let's give Vasquez some credit for that as well. Ever since the opening rounds, Vasquez has tried to make it a point to go to the body when he's done his business. It may be quick, maybe a couple of punches, a quick flurry, and he gets out, but he has not neglected the body of Shapovalov.
Is it me? Or I don't remember Vasquez throwing a straight overhand punch at all lately. I don't remember last time he threw a straight overhand punch. Everything's underneath uppercuts.
Well, let me ask you this, Ray. Is it because Shapovalov, the smaller man, comes in a little bit low, and so he wants to catch him underneath?
Sure, that's part of it, but I think that's just his boxing style.
You know,
just go right to him, throw your hands.
Seconds out, sir.
We start the 10th round here at the Venetian Resort Hotel in Macau, China, the Cotai Arena. And there's some more business taking place here.
Get out of the ring. Time in.
Between Ernest Sharif, the referee, and the corner there, Denis Shapovalov. He's giving it to Miguel Diaz over there.
You better watch. Miguel's a froggy guy, too. He could be a better fight outside the ring.
That's right.
In both corners have done a decent jobs on these cuts. Vasquez has cut over his left eye. Not really an issue, although Shapovalov's cut has just opened up a little bit. So and there you see he comes in with the quick uppercuts, the 1-2 there. Vasquez does, and then he ties up. Shapovalov caught Vasquez right there.
Good little right hand.
Blood now, though. Coming down the right side. Right into the eye of Shapovalov. So that cut now is opened up. 2 minutes left here in the 10th round, and we'll see what Vasquez does about it. Also, though, we'll see if it ignites Shapovalov.
Break.
scraping left hook from Vasquez to that right eye. Doubles up with the left hand.
Oh. Comes through with a big left hand that broke through the defense of Shafikov.
No, so let now, him go. Let him go.
Vasquez showing a little bit more urgency in the 10th round. Maybe thinking he has an opportunity. Once again, though, we've got a timeout as they have to deal with the tape on the gloves here.
You see, again, Fran, he's throwing it so far outside. If Shafikov could time it with a straight punch, I'm telling you, he'd be, you know, you're going to catch this guy, he could hurt him.
Crowd trying to fire up the Miguel Vasquez. Here in the 10th round, and that cut now wide open on Denis Shafikov. There is blood covering the right side of his face. Shafikov trying to do a little work to the body. Part of the crowd trying to fire at Vasquez. The other crowd, part of the crowd, complaining about the tie-ups here late in the fight.
There is a small Russian contingent of fight people here. Promoters, trainers.
Crowd got a little excited there with the left hook from Shafikov. March 29th on Boxing After Dark, hard-hitting Sergey Kovalev puts his light heavyweight title on the line against undefeated Cedric Agnew. Following live boxing, stay tuned for the premiere of 24/7 Pacquiao Bradley 2 as we take a closer look at their highly disputed first fight and look ahead to their April 12th rematch on HBO pay-per-view.
I gave that last round to Shafikov, so at least on my card there won't be a shutout.
Championship rounds here, Cotai Arena in Macau, China, for this lightweight championship between Miguel Vasquez and Denis Shafikov. And Vasquez, for the most part, has been able to do what he likes to do, which is box his way around the ring, stay on the outside, come in for a quick cup of coffee, and then back out. And Shafikov has not been able to find a way to cut off the ring and really tie Vasquez up, and then also see if he can find a way to get him either in the corner up against the ropes. Watch the cut over the right eye of Denis Shafikov.
At least as far as I can see, Ray, he hasn't even been better on the inside, Shafikov. I mean, he's been at his best, but Vasquez has not permitted him to do a whole lot.
No, you're absolutely right, Larry. I mean, even though Vasquez comes in, ties him up, he comes in with punches. Shafikov hasn't timed it, and then he allows him to get to Vasquez to tie him up, and he doesn't do anything.
So here's the question. If you're Miguel Angel Vasquez, and here you have an opportunity to win your 13th straight fight, you have an opportunity to win your sixth straight defense here, but people basically are saying, you know what, you're not exciting enough. How do you manage that, Ray, from a fighter's perspective, when all the outside noise potentially is more negative than positive when, as a champion, you're winning fights?
Well, the bottom line is, you just said, he is winning. And I tell you, if you keep winning, you're going to, you know, you're going to change some of those detractors. But it's just what he is. He's got to use his height. Look, he's got to use his height, his reach. And he's not a puncher. That's the bottom line. He's not a puncher.
That's right.
There are guys who are not punchers who are
more exciting.
are more exciting to watch. But, you know, You know, maybe when he gets a little older and slower, he'll have to stand and
well,
deliver.
Well,
but
you know,
yeah, this is right. What he does. And the issue is going to be our television executives going to want to put him on their networks.
You're absolutely right. And you know, you've heard the term winning ugly. You look up in the dictionary, it says pitcher.
Well, now Vasquez has Shafikov up against the ropes here. 20 seconds left in the 11th round. Blood streaming down the right side of Shafikov's face. And Larry, you're right. Even when Shafikov has been able to get inside, it's really Vasquez who's done the better work. A nice straight right hand there.
Well, that's one of the few I've seen in the right rounds.
Yeah, hasn't thrown that very much tonight. Hasn't needed to. He's gone to the uppercut, and it's worked out quite well. One more round left in this championship bout.
As bloody as this fight has been, you would think it was closer.
No, right. I mean, they're close rounds, but he's winning each of his rounds.
We've hit the 12th and final round here for this lightweight championship matchup. Miguel Angel Vasquez making his sixth title defense against the pesky Denis Shapovalov from Russia. Shafikov, no doubt about it, needs to knock Vasquez out to have any chance. If you take a look at the blood now, the cut opening up back on the right side, but just on the inside, right above Shafikov's right eye, and it's streaming down to the right side of his face.
There's that leaping left uppercut that leaves him open, but Shafikov has not been able to capitalize on it. As you've pointed out repeatedly, right?
And you know, what we've said, you know, he's not very popular back in his home country. But I'll tell you what, he's got to assume he's winning. He can take the round off and just move, but he's fighting him. You gotta give it to the guy. He's trying to make a go of it.
Shafikov almost like trying to psych himself up, trying to get his arms loose here.
Don't bend down on his
neck. He's got a buck 20 left. And he hasn't been able to really catch Vasquez all night long, so he's got a minute to see if he can catch him.
Let him go.
You know, when it's the last round, friend, and a guy like that, he's standing outside, he's still trying to, you know, he's trying to faint. And I mean, you got to make it a dogfight. Just come in and throw punches. You're going to eat some, so what, man? You're going to, you know, hopefully he's going to take one of you. Maybe you catch him with something. He's got to know he's down.
He's trying his best. His best isn't just good enough.
See? It looked like potentially he was going to end up a bit of a dogfight early on when he had the clash of heads, and then Vasquez kind of changed up his game for a minute. And was less boxer, more puncher. But then reverted back because he figured out, you know what, this is what I do, and it's worked well, and it's working well tonight. So if it ain't broke,
sometimes you still gotta fix it.
Well, it'll be interesting to see what happens next for Miguel Vasquez. As the crowd applauds the effort. It'll be interesting to see what happens next here for Vasquez moving forward, because
while he does come up with, in all likelihood, and we'll find out in a second, I'd be shocked if it went otherwise, but while it looks like he's going to come up with his 34th
victory. At no point in that fight did the champ look like he was in danger of becoming the ex-champ.
Let's take a look at the recap of the fight, Larry. And that was early on, the clash of heads. And Vasquez says, come on. And so Shapokov and Vasquez kind of stood toe-to-toe for a minute, a couple of rounds. Nice right hand there from Shapokov, but then he ended up getting the headbutt over the right side. And so we had a lot of blood, but not a lot of dramatic action. And then in the championship rounds, Vasquez pretty much knew. And if he could just continue to stay away, get in and get out and do what he does, that he should be successful in his sixth title defense. So it's going to be interesting to see what options come up next year for Vasquez. There you look at Shapokov, had a couple of cuts. One right over the right eye, and then another one that was closer to the middle of the forehead. Ray, if you're Miguel Vasquez, you like these big rings too, huh?
I'm sorry, Fred, we were being distracted because Miguel Diaz brought Shapokov over to look at yelling that they butted. You know, it's cut by headbutts. That's an ugly cut. So.
Well, it also looks like he has a gash when he bends his head down on the top of his head as well.
I'm just trying to wait and see if Miguel and the referee don't go at it pretty soon. Because they had some words.
Well, the referee looks like he's been in a fight. Look at his shirt. I've never seen a referee's shirt so bloody. Because it...
All right, so... Miguel Vasquez and Shapokov are over. Let's send it into Michael Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, here at the Venetian Macau, we go to the official scorecards. Patricia Jarman scores at 115-113. Chris Wilson, 116-112. And Sylvain LeBlanc scores it 119-109. All three scores to the winner by unanimous decision. And still, IBF lightweight champion of the world, Miguel Titere Vasquez.
So Vasquez, the winner by a unanimous decision. Patricia Jarman had it pretty close. She had it 115-113.
Well, that's why they have three judges. And the important thing is they got it right.
Absolutely. Overall, a great night here in Macau. And before we sign off, let us remind you to tune into the next Real Sports for a look back at the plane crash in Russia 2 years ago, which claimed the lives of an entire professional hockey team. And a World Championship Boxing returns on HBO Saturday, March 1st, as Julio Cesar Chavez Jr. and Brian Vera square off in their highly anticipated rematch following Chavez's disputed unanimous victory in their action-packed fight last September. Also that night, two-time Olympic champion Vasyl Lomachenko beats Orlando Salido for a featherweight title. So now for Larry Merchant, Ray Mancini, and the rest of our crew here at the Venetian Macau Resort Hotel, I'm Fran Charles saying thanks for being with us and good night.